First at 4, the mother of a man who's been missing for more than 2 years gets an escort to the site where his remains have most likely been found.
WESH 2 was there with Rachel George as she saw Lake Carter firsthand. Just yesterday, she learned her son's wallet, driver's license, and jewelry were near the remains uncovered on Tuesday. WESH 2's Dave McDaniel has been following this story since it broke. And Dave, how is Rachel George holding up?
Well, she's holding up rather well. You know, she works very hard in public to stay very analytical and calm. She says there are certainly moments in private where she gets very emotional and very sad, but she says she owes it to her son to stay on top of this investigation, make sure it's moving in the right direction. And for that, she says, staying calm matters. Escorted by Apopka's police chief, Rachel George got a close look at the site near Lake Carter, where remains have been found.
I kind of separate the reality of what that place holds. I mean, I look at the function of it.
Just yesterday, confirmation that along with the bones found yards from where Chris George's truck was found more than 2 years ago, a wallet with his driver's license, jewelry his mom identified as his.
Pretty much since early this week, I pretty much had come to terms with the fact that it's Chris.
Police say more bones have been found, not as many as Thursday. They say nothing points to a second person here.
I mean, I want to keep the focus on Rachel and Chris because that's what we're here for.
For a time this week, the parents of Tracy Ocasio had hoped clues to their missing daughter would be here as well. They have not given up hope.
They assure me that they'll be doing more than just what's happening here today.
James Hadaway is a person of interest in both disappearances. He's awaiting trial in an unrelated attempted murder in Seminole County. Rachel George has made no secret of her frustration with the way her son's case has been handled. She wants to call in Orange County for investigative help.
No, I do not want them to take over the case. I want them to participate in the case.
Now, officially, this is being called a death investigation, while Rachel George is calling it a murder investigation. Police can see that at any point it could go from a death investigation into a murder investigation. They also say that they plan to knock off here closer to sunset this evening, but they also figure they will be on site at Lake Carter easily into next week, gathering more evidence and more clues. Reporting live in Apopka, Orange County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.